Welcome everyone to a topic which may not fit a hard industry debate but is equally if not more important. How do we make our buildings safe? Our high-rise apartments, our tall office buildings and even our standalone homes. In February 2010, 9 people lost their lives and 70 were severely injured in a major fire that broke out in Carlton Towers in Bengaluru, a multi-storied commercial complex. The tragic incident brought together the survivors, friends and relatives of those who lost their lives and citizens who are concerned about safety to form Beyond Carlton, a group. This group is committed to ensure that something like this never happens again. And today on this show, we will get to the bottom of how do we make our buildings safe to live in from fire, from natural disasters and make sure that this never happens again to you or to me or any family member or friend. Let me introduce my panel to you today. M.B. Deshmukh, Director, Maharashtra Fire Services, joins us from our Mumbai studio. Mr. Deshmukh, pleasure to have you with us, sir. Alpha Sheth, a well-known structural engineering and managing director, VMS Group. Alpha, thanks for making the time. Chandresh Mehta, Director, Rustam Ji, to give us a developer's perspective on what they're doing with buildings to make them safe for you and me. Chandresh, thanks so much for making it to the studio. Also be joined by Uday Vijayan, Managing Trustee and President of Beyond Carlton. But with me here in the Delhi studio is S.K. Dheri, Head of Fire Safety of DLF, India's largest developer. Mr. Dheri, thank you very much for joining in. Okay, so let me just revisit that incident. And of course, it was Beyond Carlton Group which approached us. We got into looking at the incidents and the deaths due to fire accidents. And we found that the numbers have actually rapidly been increasing over the last 4 years. If you go back to the Carlton incident, what really happened? The windows of the air-conditioned buildings were closed. Smoke from the duct engulfed the offices. Most of the employees on the 7th and 6th and 7th floors were in the habit of using only the lift. They did not know where the staircase was located. Can you believe that? And that caused deaths and severe damages. Mr. Deshmukh, what do you do in a case like this? I mean, let's start with the Carlton incident which happened in Bengaluru, which has got a group to come together and highlight this issue. What should have been done?
Thank you, Manisha. This is a subject of a concern for the every citizen of this country. And I'm happy that the NDTV is breaking the ice on this topic again and again. We need to really pave the way out. The major issue here is it the architect's responsibility? It is the responsibility of the developer. It is the responsibility of the fire department. It is the responsibility of the regulators. We always keep on passing the bucks. My 32 years of experience, and I'm sure our senior colleague Mr. Dheri also would vouch for my statement that the major problem here with our country is nothing but an attitude. An attitude of the people, concern of the people for their own safety is a major challenge that we face as a firefighters. Number two, you ask me what do we do about this in Maharashtra. I am the facilitator for the whole state, as the Maharashtra doesn't have the unified state fire service, but I have a pivotal role to play here. So here what we do, the most important that here what we do is we are trying to bring a lot of control on the glass facade buildings. There is always a head-on collusion between the safety and the security. As a safety purpose for the means of egress, we demand for the number of staircases according to the travel distance, according to the floor plate of the building and the type of the building. At the same time, the security purpose, these staircases are either often kept under lock and key. For the glass facade buildings, we ask for the 15% of the openings where from either the firefighters can have access or the people can have access at least to inhale the fresh air to breathe. Now, these norms are grossly violated. There is also a debatable issue. I think it should be discussed independently whether the glass facade buildings are really encouraged in a country like India. If you ask me, the answer is straight no, but it is a fashion and people want it, so we have to survive with it. Now, these glass facade buildings always have a challenge to the firefighters. Now, in a closed envelope kind of these buildings, whatever the building management system you have, the major problem is the smoke. Carlton, I visited immediately after the tragedy, and even we had one workshop in Bangalore where Mr. Udayan was also with us. And the tragedy there was the staircases were locked. There was no proper access to people to get out of the building. And these are the few challenges where we are trying to concentrate. The Maharashtra has taken a very aggressive step to bring in a law which is enforcing the provisions made in the National Building Code. I think this is a unique step that the state has taken. Now, this is a change management process. We are facing a lot of resistance from the different corners, but our colleagues are working very hard to ensure that this law is in step by step implemented in a stricter than the possible manners. I think if this law is properly implemented in Maharashtra and being implemented, we think the buildings are becoming more and more safe in Maharashtra, though there are many old buildings prior to this legislation came in force. That also is another challenge. Second thing is, these buildings, though they are once commissioned as per the fire regulation and the fire act, the issue is whether the systems provided are maintained on a sustainable basis.